It's morning somewhere.
Yeah, it's a good afternoon. But game was what I saw on Saturday, you know. Just this one. You know, there's certain situations that we got to be better at. Offense scored 10 points in the first half. Came back in the second, scored 7. So we got outscored 21-7 in the second half. Defense played a pretty good game, but you know, there's still just a little bit of discipline things, details. Guys just got to sacrifice certain stuff for them to, for the team to obtain the goals that we're trying to get to. So I think once we get that, and you have to earn the right to win. You know, I think they had a really good week of practice last week, but it still wasn't enough. So I'm excited to see how they approach tonight, and that'll give me a good feeling on how we're going to do the rest of the week.
When it comes to discipline, is there anything you can do in practice to simulate anything to get them prepared for that, or is that one of those things that you just have to be able to do in a game?
I mean, you try to do the discipline just in different situations, like guys tucking their shirts in, being in the meeting at a certain time, just stuff that makes you know that they're bought in, you know, but a lot of stuff is happening to us towards the end of the game, so when fatigue kicks in a little bit, they're not exactly executing the way that they need to, but it's all fixable, you know, and we got the penalties down to 5, Penn State, so I was kind of excited about that, and then we jumped back up to 10, so, you know, we're going to stay at it. You know, these guys want to be coached, and they want that tough love, and you know, we're going to just continue to preach to them the right stuff, and hopefully it just resonates.
You keep mentioning discipline. How much of that is on the coaches?
It is. It's all of us on the coaches. All of us on me. So it wouldn't be one of my pillars if I didn't think it was really important. So I just have to continue to reiterate it to the team and have them truly understand what it means. You know, it's not just a word. You know, it's more actions. So we have to fix our actions out there on the field and stop getting in our own way.
I know hindsight can be, you know, kind of coulda, woulda, shoulda, but when you think back to 4th and 1, they had no timeouts. You only needed a yard to, you know, basically ice the game. Was it just the field position that kind of dictated things on that?
Yeah, the field position really dictated the thing. Like you said, they didn't have any timeouts, but were we on the 12?
I think you started on the 3.
Exactly. I was about to put it on like the 20, but the fact that it was on the 12, it was just field position. If we would have had just a little bit more space, then I would have trusted us to go out there and just get the first down. But the way that we were running the ball and just the situations that had happened in that game before coming up to that weren't necessarily ideal, so that situation really did play into that.
What about into the first half? You stopped them, I think it was like 1:44, didn't call a timeout, and then you needed that time at the end of the half. You had to kick a field. What was the thinking there?
That we had enough time still. It's easy to go back and say, well, if we do this at this time and this at that time, but at the exact time at that moment, I thought that the situation we were good, but you know, we ended up didn't run out of time, have to kick a field goal, but there's nothing saying that there was more time that we would have scored, so I'm not going to play into that game. You got to just make a decision and go with that.
How about Tabaki as the 6th offensive lineman? How did you like that? Will you keep doing that some?
That's more game plan stuff, so I don't want to necessarily touch him, but he came in and played in the game.
What does that say about the offensive line? You know, they've gone through a few changes this year about their just intelligence, willingness to move different spots.
Coach Castillo does a good job of multi-training guys so they can play multiple positions and not just the position that they play. So the fact that he can come in and help us at the tight end spot and block and know what motions he needs to go on and shift and everything, that was pretty good. So I was just excited for him to get out there and play.
I wanted to ask you a question about the process of the injury, the status reports. You know, how does that work? Do you assess it at the end of the week, then submit it to the Big Ten?
Yes, so we do go over that, and then I give it to my guy that sends it to the Big Ten.
Two targeting calls, one of them got overturned, obviously, but is that like a discipline, toughness, balance? Like, what is kind of the balance you're trying to strike
there? The targeting, the one with Kwazi, it's, that was close, you know? We got one earlier in the year that was targeting, but this last game, it was more shoulder to me, so it's kind of just up to the referees to call if you want to or not. You know? To be honest with you, most tackles or most people running the ball or whatnot, ball carriers, you can almost call targeting on every situation if you really wanted to. Because that one, they said that he led with a crown on his helmet. So anytime a defender comes at you, you're running back. Exactly, being targeted on how it is. So it's kind of up to the nature of the ref on what he wants to do.
And then on Minnesota's go-ahead touchdown late, I think you're racing down the sideline, called timeout. Was there something you just didn't like in what you guys were lined up in, or did you see something in Minnesota's formation?
No, it was something that we weren't in the right position, so we had to call timeout in this situation.
I don't know if you can comment on this, but that one penalty, pulling the player off of the pile, what did you see from that?
It's just that they warned us of that already, so they don't want one team pulling the other team off of each other. And we got called on that twice, and then we got to delay a game, so I know those are discipline things. That's a discipline issue. That's something that's somebody making a choice to do something that's already been told not to do it. So that's a discipline. Stuff that the referees are calling, that's not necessarily a discipline issue. Maybe if it was people jumping off sides or false starts like we were doing before, which was a discipline thing, but we had kind of corrected that. So that was just unfortunate that the time that it came and just what happened, the outcome.
Rutgers seems to have a pretty decent run game, and you guys are proving to have continuing to have a good run defense. How do you see that matchup playing out?
It's going to match up pretty well. You know, that running back's really good. He actually played with Berger. He went to the same high school. So I actually saw him play in high school. He's a good back, runs hard. You got to wrap him up. He's not just going to go down if you hit him. So he's a back that we're going to have to wrap up. And, I'm confident in my defense, and I know they're excited for the challenge.
Realize the untapped potential that you have there?
I think that they're just seeing it in spurts, so if we can find a way to truly put a four-quarter game together, then you know, you can really see the potential. But the offense is still trying to operate a high-powered offense, and you know, I have confidence in that. I think the players do too, especially when they are making plays in certain situations. It's just not enough plays, and it's just not consistent enough. So, it's still new to these guys, you know, it's still a new offense. But I'm not going to make any excuses. We should be able to run the ball a little bit better, and we should be able to protect him a little bit better also.
What was your assessment of Ethan in his first game back? I know one of the interceptions was tipped, the other one was a Hail Mary, so kind of maybe take us off the board a little bit. What do you think about his play?
And the other one, what happened to the other one?
The other one was hit the ground.
There you go. There you go. So he said it, I did. It was just three unfortunate plays. You know, one was tipped and still goes on his stats. But I think he did a good job of responding, moving in the pocket, you know, coming back and just being a true leader. You know, guys still rallied behind him, and you know, it was just unfortunate. You know, the game to me really just came down to turnovers and penalties. That's how we lost this game. We lost the turnover and penalties. We just got to do a better job of protecting the football.
I'm not trying to get you in trouble, but when they replay a play and it looks like it hits the ground and everybody can see it and it stands, I mean, what's the value of replay then, right?
Exactly. It's very unfortunate, but you know, there was about 60 other plays that we could have made out there that we should have made, so I'm not going to just put everything on that one play, but you know, it wasn't exactly ideal for us in this situation.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.